Well, before we get going here, I think we do need to make mention of the Dynamite rating, which was not good. We normally don't talk a lot about ratings on this show, but this one is notable because the show did 747,000 viewers and a 0.23. The 0.23, according to WrestleNomics here, is the lowest 18 to 49. Are you ready for this? Mm-hmm. Dating back to June 24 of 2020.
During the pandemic?
It is now 2024. This is the lowest 18 to 49 in nearly 4 years.
They had a rating from Daily's Place during the pandemic? Wow.
Yes, yes. Now, I will say this. It is a week. I don't think that this is necessarily something to panic about yet. This could be panic-worthy, but I don't think we should panic today.
No.
Because there are anomalies that occur. There are things that happen. You know, if this is a trend and we start getting down to 2022 or 2020 numbers and 18 to 49, then there's something to talk about. But, you know, it's 1 week. And the thing about the show is, you know, I think the most notable thing is it averaged, you know, right around 700,000. It did not average what it normally does. It started a little lower. It just trended lower throughout the entire evening. And that's it. You know, it opened up with 939, and it just fell off a cliff over the next half hour for the Shibata match, the beginning of the Young Bucks match. I mean, it dropped all the way down to 711 in the first half hour. The Young Bucks match did gain 50,000 viewers. I know people like to say the Young Bucks are, you know, they killed the rating and everything. They actually grew 50,000 for their segment. And it stayed there for about a half hour and then fell again. You know, the appearance of Mercedes doing commentary meant nothing. I mean, 771, no spike, nothing. And it fell. And the only other good thing is, you know, the number one contenders match. I mean, they did grow pretty significantly, actually, for the overrun. They grew from 658 to 724. Which is very good for the overrun.
What's the show after it?
I couldn't even tell you.
Because if the show after it is popular, then the overrun will do great because people are switching over.
That's true, but I mean, we watch the overrun most weeks, and the overrun usually doesn't grow that much, if any. It's usually very, very minor. 658 at 724 is pretty, that was good growth. So, you know, part of it was a show coming after, but I think part of it also was people really wanted to see who won. And Modern Family rerun is the answer.
So probably not.
Yeah, not a good number at all. The 1849 was flat out terrible, but it is one day, so we'll give it some time to see what happens.
I was thinking just on ratings because you know, Dave and you were talking. We even talked on our last show about, you know, holding those people from the previous show as long as possible to help boost your rating. And then I thought about it. I think it was because I was actually watching TV and I realized what you do now. And it's like, I would imagine those viewers that they hold for a few minutes at the beginning aren't even watching the show. They punch the menu button on their television and are probably scrolling through the menu looking to see what they're going to watch next. And technically, the channel hasn't been changed yet until they actually select their next one. So those first few minutes, there's a good chance that even if you had the greatest thing in the world, it's not going to hook anybody because they've got their menu on the screen and they aren't actually watching.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of that based on the drop we get at the beginning of every show. But anyway, the only other thing I want to say is, you know, if you watched wrestling and you follow the ratings dating back to the 90s, I mean, there's never a situation where things go way up 1 week and stay there. Things go way down 1 week and stay there. It's always gradual. You know, when WCW, when Nitro took off, it was a gradual rise. It was not, you know, they booked one big match and then it was, you know, to the moon. The only thing that you could really say is that WrestleMania 1998, when Steve Austin beat Shawn Michaels to win the title, They never lost to Nitro again, starting the next day. So, you know, that's the closest you're going to get to one singular incident turning things around. But, I mean, they were on the rise before he won the title. And it wasn't like, you know, they went way up that next day. It was just that was the day that Nitro never won again. So, you know, AEW, I thought there were some good changes they made on the show. You know, I like their video packages. They've always been kind of afraid to air video packages. And, you know, I'm hoping
we'll get them again now.
Yeah, I'm hoping they don't just get rid of them completely because this was a terrible rating. Like, whatever changes they make that are positive, it's never going to turn it around in 1 week. And whatever mistakes people make on any show, it never turns it around in 1 week. It is a slow, gradual rise and a slow, gradual fall. AEW is on a decline right now. WWE is on an incline. But, I mean, it's slow and steady. So what you just hope for is let's turn this thing around. And it's going to take a while, but let's get going on it. So anyway, am I doing the report, I presume, Lance?
You're probably going to have to lead, yes.
All right. I hate leading. I do it on every other show. So it opened up with the Bryan Danielson or the William. Let me start over again. Started out with Will Ospreay versus Shibata. And I really liked the fact that they showed clips of Shibata and Ospreay's match from 2017. Because often, you know, you will have the announcers talk about history, but we don't see it. And sometimes announcers talk about real history. Sometimes announcers make up storyline history. But to me, I don't want to be told. I want to be shown. And they showed me footage of their last match. I thought that was great. And I thought this match was a very good match. I would say for a TV match, it was excellent. It was not your usual blow-away Will Ospreay match. It was a different kind of match. He worked a Shibata match. And it was, you know, we had somebody on the board angry when I said it was a WWE crowd. They said, I don't want to hear that. Just say it's a good crowd or a bad crowd. Well, it was neither a good crowd or a bad crowd. It was a WWE crowd. There were things that they were really into. Entrances, big spots, people that have been in WWE before. But other stuff like the kick out at one, which in New Japan would just get an enormous reaction. You know, before a AEW pay-per-view audience, it would get a huge reaction. It did not get much of a reaction here. But, you know, they cheered Ospreay. They liked him a lot. They liked the match. Ospreay hit the Hidden Blade, got the pin. They bowed to each other afterwards. And as far as wrestling goes, I mean, great opener.
Yeah, I really like the video packages a lot. Because I'm a wrestling fan and I watch a lot of wrestling. But I haven't watched a lot of New Japan wrestling over the years. So Shibata, I know who he is. I know the injury story, but it's like, I'm not really super familiar with Shibata. So this video really helped, because if you're not familiar with Shibata, which I would imagine a lot of people were or aren't, he's a guy that I don't know if we've seen him win on television. And it's like, we know the result of this match. Danielson beat him. They're building to Danielson Ospreay, so we know the finish. It's like, you got to give Shibata as much credibility and noteworthiness to fans that aren't watching all of New Japan and know the history. So I thought the video package was great. And like you say, it was a good opener. It's just Will Ospreay is in that horrible position where if he doesn't have a match of the year, you're almost disappointed. It's like, this was a really enjoyable match. I was a little uncomfortable at times with the headshots, knowing the history of Shibata, but it was a good opener.
Hey guys, did you love this clip? If so, you should join our channel. Just hit the join button and you'll have full access to every single show that we do. Wrestling Observer Live, Wrestling Observer Radio, The Bryan and Vinny Show, all of them in full HD, full length, plus archives of all of your favorite shows. Click join today and don't miss out.